Let us analyze the case of vertical circular motion of a pendulum with light rigid rod. Till now we have studied about a simple pendulum and the cases of vertical circular motion of its bob. In case of a simple pendulum, we have used a string. Now we have changed the case slightly and we have replaced the string by a light vertical rigid rod. Now if the rod is hanging from a point, and at the other end of the rod, a pendulum bob is there, and if we throw it with the speed u, obviously it will move up. The cases are almost all similar to that of a simple pendulum, except the one when the initial speed is more than root 2 gl. We have studied that the initial speed, if it is root 2 gl, the bob is able to reach the horizontal position. If a speed is more than root 2 gl, it will certainly cross the horizontal position and reach in the upper half of the circle, where it may be possible, depending on the initial speed, that at some point the tension, the string becomes zero and the bob will start following a projectile motion. Unlike to that case, in case of a vertical rigid rod, if we throw it at a particular angle theta, the tension in the rod can never be equal to zero. Like we consider the case when u is equals to root 4 gl that we already studied in case of a simple pendulum. In this situation, if it is root 4 gl, we have studied that this is the minimum required speed to take the bob to the topmost point if tension will support. Here we can say in this situation, tension will never become zero and bob will be able to reach the top and finally it will fall and it may complete the circular motion. If it was a string, then we know well that at a particular position, at an angle theta is equals to cos inverse of minus 2 by 3, the tension in the string becomes 0. Till this point, the tension was providing the centripetal force because of which the bob was continuing the circular motion. But when there is a rod, we can say up to this point, there was an inward force applied by the rod on the bob, but after this point, as the tension in the string becomes zero, here tension in the rod may become zero, but rod will never slack. So rod will support the bob and it will start pushing the bob in outward direction and it will continue the circular motion and will reach the top when its velocity becomes zero at the topmost position. And in case of a string, the bob will never be able to reach the topmost position. So we can say, if u is equals to root 4 gl in case of a light rigid rod, bob will complete the circle as rod will never slack. If it is able to reach the topmost position, here it will further fall if it is having a speed slightly more than root 4 gl. And one more point which is important to understand, you can keep it as a note, where we can write after theta is equals to cos inverse of minus 2 by 3, the direction of force by rod on bob changes from inward to outward. As string can never apply outward force, as soon as tension becomes zero, the string becomes slack and it will start following a projectile motion. But in case of a rigid rod, it will never happen.